Today we're running a sample of canola on our lab unit. Our lab unit consists of 4 inner flights of all different sizes. We have a 6-inch, a 5-inch, a 4-inch, and a 3-inch inner flight. Depending on what type of material you're running will depend on which inner flight you're running material on. Our hopper lifts and turns and positions on the inner flight that you want to run your material. Today we're going to be running our canola on a 6-inch inner flight, so we'll position it there. The hopper has an adjustable flow so we can meter the proper amount of material into that flight. The inner flights is where the separation process starts. As the material starts flowing down the inner flights, the round material will roll off the inner flight and end up in our outer flight. The non-rounds will stay in the inner flight because it does not get enough momentum to come off the inner flights. All of the inner flights end up in the same place in this discharge chute right down here, which is called the non-round discharge chute. All of our round materials will end up in this chute down here, which is called our round discharge chute. We will run our sample now. And here we can see the material flowing down both the inner flight and the outer flight. And here we see the round material being discharged to the discharge chute. And over here is the non-rounds on the inner plate being discharged to the discharge chute. And we have our round material on the left and our non-round material on the right. And that concludes our sample of canola going through our lab unit. See our other videos on our other machines that we manufacture for separating materials from 40 micron all the way up to 9600 micron. Either powdered metal, steel shot, cut wire, soybeans, seeds of any type.